Hey everybody, it's Mitch from the Istio project at Google, and I want to talk to you today about how easy it is to get started with Istio on Google Cloud. For today's talk, I'm going to take the role of a site reliability engineer, or SRE, who's responsible for operating a lot of services, so many that I don't necessarily know what all of them do or what all of their dependencies are. But I'm an SRE for the book info site, and my site is misbehaving. This page looks pretty good, but I'm hearing users complain that sometimes the page is taking a really long time to load. Other times they're seeing errors on the page. I don't know where the telemetry is for these services. I've looked through the logs and I don't see what's wrong with them. But obviously you can see right here, error fetching product reviews. Other users are reporting errors with the rating service not being available. Oh, there it is. Rating service currently unavailable. My service has some problems and I need some help. I'm not able to figure this out. Looking in my Kubernetes cluster, I can see that I've got my four services here. I'm familiar with product page. That was the landing that we're just on. I've got these other services and I can roughly say what they do based on their names, but I really don't know what the dependencies are between them or what could be causing this behavior even after looking through the logs. By the way, if you want to follow along with this demo, you can use the link right here to apply the manifests and follow along. This is a pretty standard book info service. It's the Istio demo, but it's got a few tweaks to help it to misbehave so that we have something to troubleshoot. All right, so I'm going to take a look in my Kubernetes cluster and show that all of my pods have only one container running. That is, I've not onboarded to Istio yet. And I will skip the part of looking through the logs. Suffice it to say, I wasn't able to figure out what's going wrong with my services. And now what I want to do is onboard as quickly as I can to Istio and see how quickly we can get results from the service mesh that will help me to troubleshoot the dependencies between my service. So I'm going to run this install command real quickly. I'm using the demo profile for this because this is a demo. In real life, you might want to take a look at some of our other profiles for production hardening, integrating with your certificate service of choice, etc. But we're going to use the demo profile today. Almost done here. All right, Istio is available on our cluster. Now what we want to do is tell Istio that it needs to manage all of my services in the default namespace. And we're going to do that with this labeling command, istio.io revision equals default. All right, now that our namespace is labeled, I'm going to restart my workloads. See each of them restarting slowly, and as each of them restarts, I'm going to see that they spin up with two containers rather than one. You can see all of the new containers that are not in terminating status have two containers each. One of those containers is going to be the Istio proxy, and that's where all the magic happens. For this demo, I'm also going to apply the add-on sample. That's going to give me a default Prometheus, Jaeger installation, etc., for us to have a look at some telemetry information. All right, and while that's going through, I'm going to go back to my bookstore app and I'm going to generate some traffic. I don't have a load balancer as a part, or sorry, a load generator as a part of this demo. So I'm just going to hit the refresh button several times. Ooh, this one didn't load reviews at all. Let's get a few more in there. That one looks good. Oh, we're taking a long time again. Something's definitely wrong with my service. And what we're going to do today is identify the root cause of the problem. And then in a future episode, we're going to dig into how, without making any code changes, we can make this problem disappear for our users. All right, I think that's about enough load. Now I'm going to go ahead and start up the Grafana dashboard using my Istio control tool and click my link. All right, and we're going to browse dashboards. Istio comes with a default set of dashboards, and I think overall what I want to see is, how's my mesh doing? Looks like we've got a half an operation per second. They're all succeeding, which is not exactly what I'm seeing up front. So that, in the beginning, gives me pause. Here I've got three of the four services listed. We can see success rates. Things look pretty good. Oh, but here's a weird number. My P99 latency here. While it's 4 or 5 milliseconds for the reviews, this review service, for the rating service, it's 10 seconds. And for this review service, it's not a number. So let's dig into that with the Istio services dashboard. Go ahead and open that up and expand the general section. We want to look specifically, let's look at reviews first. Okay, so my P99 latency is way up there at 5 seconds, but my P50 is down to 25 milliseconds. So it's generally responding really quickly, but occasionally it's taking as much as 5 seconds to respond. That's a little bit strange. Overall, everything else here, I don't see a success rate, which is a little surprising. Let's go through ratings. Well, ratings looks even worse. My P99 latency here is at 10 seconds. So at this point, looking at this, I have a pretty good idea what's going on in my service. I can see that I've got two services that are taking an extra long time to respond. I don't yet know why, but I suspect that what's happening on the client side, or rather as this service is loading the page, the requests are timing out. So the front end page is not waiting for those services to respond. And this looks like its failure message when it has a timeout on the back end. So already within just a few minutes, I've been able to onboard my service mesh to Istio, and I've been able to begin deriving value. In our next episode, we're going to dig into analyzing exactly what is causing this high latency and see what we can do to remediate it in 5 minutes or less. We'll see you then.